Welcome to the demo Parts Catalog Generator Basic Operation. In this demo, we will show you the typical procedure to create an online parts catalog from a drawing and a parts list that come from separate sources and have no electronic links to each other in any way. The basic workflow consists of four phases, which correspond to the four tabs in the main application window. These are Model, Analyze, Review, and Publish. In the model phase, we will import the drawing and the parts information file that we want to publish, and we'll prepare them to be linked to each other. In the Analyze phase, we are going to tell PCG what to look for in the drawing. We want to make sure that only the position numbers are selected and not other textual information that may be present in the drawing. In the review phase, we will check the results of the analysis. If the results need improvement, we can return to the analyze phase and alter the settings, or we can correct individual faults in the data in this step. In the publish phase, we can determine what to publish and for whom. So, let's get started. In the model phase, we will create a new project, add a drawing to that project, import a parts list into the project, and map the part list to the drawing. When we start up Parts Catalog Generator, it opens up with a dialog screen where we must create a new project. We are asked to name the project and to specify the location for it to be saved to. Hit OK and we enter the main application window. We are automatically directed to the first phase of the process, to the Model tab. Here we will import the drawings and the parts list, and we will tell PCG what goes with what. We have several options to import the source material. We can import the drawings first in PDF format, or we can open a structured parts list from which PCG will find the related drawings to import, or we can import data via a mechanical tree. In this demo, we will use the first option. We will first import a drawing, then add a parts list, and then map the parts list information to the drawing. So we select the drawing and click Open. The drawing is added to the Assemblies and Parts list on the Structure tab. The next step is to add the parts list to the drawing. With the drawing selected, we press the Assign Parts List to Assembly button. A window opens up where we can add a parts list via the button Import Parts List. We can import parts list information from different sources, like a bill of materials exported from a partbook PDF or a data export from a database like SAP. A pop-up window shows us the contents of the parts list and offers us the possibility of assigning the number of rows for the head information. Hit OK and we see the parts list show up in the list window. With the list selected, we now hit the Create New Mapping button to define how the information from the parts list will be mapped to the output bill of materials. You are free to map as many or as few of these columns as you wish, except for one required field, and that's the part number field, which will map the position numbers from the drawing to the part numbers from the list. However, as you can still determine which columns to publish via the publishing preferences, we advise you to map as many columns as possible. As you can see here, PCG has already mapped several columns automatically, but in case of the quantity field, not quite correctly. So we select the quantity field, and from the drop-down list, we select the column amount. This Excel file contains article descriptions in four languages, and of course, we would like to make use of that in our parts catalog. So we select the description field, select article description English from the drop-down menu, and we set translatable to yes. Immediately, a plus sign appears in front of the description field. When we click that, we see a number of languages displayed. English was assigned already, so now we assign article description DE from the drop-down list to the German language. French is not there, so we leave that as it is. And we assign the Dutch description and finally the Chinese description. So now we hit OK and OK again, and our mapping for the drawing is done. By hitting the Next button, we move to the next step in the process, the Analyze tab. In the Analyze phase, we are going to tell PCG what to look for in the drawing. We want to make sure that only the position numbers are selected and not other textual information that may be present in the drawing. So, we will set the character height for the position numbers, and we may set some advanced options, like defining areas such as borders and white spaces, which will be omitted from the identification process and from publishing, defining filtering for the parts information, and adjusting process settings to achieve better results from the identification process. These advanced options will be dealt with in separate demos. With the drawing selected, we hit the Set Character Height button. This opens up a low resolution preview of the drawing, where we zoom in a bit on one of the position numbers. And then we click on the button with the black character S in the blue rectangle. And then we click on the number in the drawing. A green field appears and the character is highlighted in red. This means PCG has successfully identified this character. We hit OK. We can set quite a number of different advanced options here to optimize the results of the identification process, but we will leave that for a different demo. What we will do, however, is to check the enclosed numbers option. When we were looking at the drawing just now, we saw that the position numbers were enclosed in circles. That offers us the possibility to optimize the identification process here by telling PCG to only look for enclosed numbers in the drawing. So we select circle from the list and we select ellipse as well, as we can't be sure that all of the circles are perfectly circular. Now we will proceed with the analysis. We hit the button that states Analyze one drawing. The button turns into a process bar and below it the process steps are displayed. When the process is finished, we are automatically switched to tab number 3, Review. In the review phase, we will check the results of the analysis. If the results need improvement, we can return to the analyze phase and alter the settings, or we can correct individual faults in the data in this step. We will check whether all of the numbers in the drawing have been identified correctly and whether they have been mapped to the corresponding numbers of the parts list. Contrary to other parts catalog software, PCG has been designed to work with all sorts of input material, not just data of perfect quality. Now, especially if you work with imperfect data, like poorly scanned drawings or incomplete parts list, you should always review the results from the analyze phase. Even if you have a large number of drawings, you should at least pick some at random to make sure everything went according to plan. Now, if the results are not perfect, you can either go back to the analyze phase and use the advanced settings to further optimize the process, or you can compensate for individual faults in the data right here. So, with the drawing selected in the list, we hit the Review Results button. A preview opens up and we can see here that all of the position numbers have been correctly identified and mapped to the corresponding numbers in the parts list. So we hit OK. Now we can proceed to the last step, the publishing. So hit the button Next. In the publish phase, we can determine what to publish and for whom. We check the publishing preferences for the drawing, and finally, we publish the parts catalog. As you can see, we can set a number of options here, but we will leave that for the advanced demos. So let's publish. Okay, so here we have our output. You can see that the numbers in the bill of materials correspond to the numbers in the drawing. And when we double click a number, the part information window opens. We can order a part right here by setting the order quantity. Hit close. The part is now selected in the bill of materials. And if we open up our shopping basket, we see it contains one item, which we can view by clicking on it. And yes, it is our part, so close again and email the order. So all we need to do now is enter our name, etc., and we can order our spare part online. Well, this concludes our demo parts catalog generator basic operation. For more information on the various advanced options, you should take a look at the advanced option demos from the list. Thank you for watching this demo. Goodbye.